Good morning, Westside. Thank you for joining us for Sunday morning worship. Please stay tuned for some important announcements immediately following the service.
Yeah. Amen, amen. Welcome, 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 Westside Worldwide. We are so grateful, so thankful that you have chosen to worship with us once again. We invite you to just move freely. Let the Spirit have His way today, and we are going to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Emmanuel, we are here to worship Him. I am John McIver, and I have the great privilege of giving you our call to worship with. And I will begin with our scripture reading. Our scripture reading today will come from Matthew. Matthew chapter 1. I'll read verses 18 through 25. Matthew chapter 1, 18 to 25. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. But while he thought about those things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And she will bring forth a son. And you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him and took to him his wife and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Let us pray. Precious Lord, we thank you, dear God, that you chose to come through 42 generations, dear God, and you took a body and you took a name, and at that name demons tremble, dear God. At that name all of our troubles just wash away, at the name of Jesus. And Lord, during this season and every other season, we give you glory, we give you honor, and we give you praise. Lord, move freely in this place. Let your Spirit take full control, dear God. Father, we just want to be reckless in our worship unto you, dear God. Father, we thank you today, we glorify you today, we magnify you today, dear God. And Lord, we just say thank you for all you've done. Thank you for all you're doing, dear God. And thank you for the great and mighty things you are about to do. It is in Jesus' name that I pray, and in Jesus' name that I give thanks. Amen and hallelujah.
Amen. Come on, let's put those hands together wherever you are, Westside Worldwide. If you're in your living room, if you're in your backyard, if you're in your car, put your hands together and give God a hand clap of praise. I know you're still in the bed. Go ahead and get out the bed, get on your feet, and give God a hand clap of praise. David says in Psalm 34 that I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. David says at all times, in good times, yeah, in bad times. Yes, in 2020, we will praise his name. We will bless his name. We will adore his name. We will exalt him. We will extol him, because we serve a great God. I'll praise your name. We honor you, O Lord. Have your way in our lives. Your name, your holy name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, not just today, but always, now and forever. Lord, I praise your name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, not just today, but always. Now and forever, Lord, I praise your name. Help me sing that.
I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name.
Not just today,
not just today,
but always. Now and forever, Lord, I praise your name. Let's sing it again. Lord, I praise.
I praise your name,
your holy name.
Your holy name. I praise your name, your holy name. I praise your name.
himself comes down. Come on, here we go. When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down.
Blessings come down.
When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down.
Blessings come down.
When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down.
Blessings come down.
When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down.
Blessings come down.
When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down.
Praises come down.
When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down. When praises go up,
praises go up,
blessings come down. When praises go up,
praise God.
Blessings come.
Hear me now.
When praises go up,
praise God.
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 When praises go up,
everybody clap your hands. Everybody clap your hands.
Here we go, from the top. I'll praise your name.
I'll praise your name, your holy name. I'll praise your name, your holy name. I'll praise your name.
Not just today.
Not just today.
But always.
But always.
Now and.
Now and forever.
One more time.
I'll praise your name. I'll praise your name.
Your holy name.
Your holy name.
I'll praise your name.
I'll praise your name.
Not just today, but
not
always.
Just today,
but always.
But always.
Now and forever.
Now and forever. Lord, I praise your name.
Come on, clap those hands and give God praise.
Amen, amen. We celebrate the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I'm here to just give you our few brief announcements. As always, make sure you come and take part, be a participant in all of our Zoom activities throughout the week. Visit your various ministry web pages and you'll hear more information about that. On this Sunday, tonight at 7 o'clock p.m., make sure you tune in for our men's virtual Christmas concert. You know it is amazing every year, and we didn't let the pandemic get in the way. It is going down again, our Christmas concert. It is going to bless you. That is tonight at 7 p.m. Also, our special guest will be George Power, recording artist George Power will take part in that. In closing, I just like for you to make sure that we are lifting up one another in prayer. It is so important. And in your prayers, be specific and lift up the Gorman family. We lost our beloved Sister Annie this week. And so please lift up Sister Valerie Gorman, her husband, Deacon Jim Gorman, and all of Sister Annie's family. With that, I will open the floor.
All the people of God said amen. How we bless God. I'm just ecstatic at the name Emmanuel. I praise your name. I was sitting there just thinking how this ministry continues to bless us. In times of challenge, it gives us something on the inside, so that what's on the outside won't destroy us. I was thinking as they were talking about Emmanuel, can you imagine how Joseph must have felt when he had a legal agreement that Mary was going to be his wife, and instead she said, I'm pregnant. And Joseph says, who is the father? He said, this is of the Holy Spirit. God has done this. And the Bible says something interesting about Joseph. said that because Joseph was an honorable man, he was going to put her away quietly. And when you make up in your mind you just want to do right, God has a way of honoring that. Because while he was trying to hide the shame of sin, the Bible says that that night the Holy Spirit came. And instead of the shame of sin, there was the surprise of the Spirit. The Holy Spirit said, no, it is so. And then the Holy Spirit says something interesting. You're going to call his name Jesus because he's going to save us from our sins. You know what we run past in the Bible? That every time we say the name Jesus, we bless Jesus, Yeshua, Joshua, God is our salvation. That the reason Jesus' name is Jesus is because Joseph was obedient. Mary didn't name him. Joseph did. And God honored that obedience. I thank God that if you're faithful, you don't have to be famous. Insert shout here. That every time we say Jesus, Joseph gets another star in his crown. You just do what God tells you, and thou shalt call his name Jesus. Just wanting to do right, not trying to shame him. And the Holy Ghost said, God's in charge. I'm excited that you get to worship with us on this Sunday morning where we celebrate the contributions, not just of our children and youth ministries, but of our children and youth and even our young adult ministers, those who serve them. And as we are in this season of what God has given to us, it is always fitting that when we come before the Lord, we bring God a gift. I've come to God with an offering. I offer him the sacrifice of praise, but I also offer him the sacrifice of my possessions. The older I get, the more I clearly understand the difference between a possession and a gift. Whatever I have that I want to call mine, I understand that every good and perfect gift comes from God. And I've come to bring God a portion of that. They don't belong to me. I'm just a steward. And I've come to give God a portion of what he has given to me. I'm grateful. Because you know what God could do is God could keep the 90 and give me the 10. But God gave me the full 100 and said, I'm going to trust you to give me the 10 back. We are a congregation of tithers and we are a tithing congregation. We invite those of you who believe as we do to join with us. You can give on our website, wbcchurch.org/give. You're able to text and give to WBC Church to 77977 and you'll get instructions on how to give. You're able to give through our app on both Apple and on Google, and you're able to mail your checks to 900 Bel Air Boulevard here in Lewisville, Texas, 75067. I want to give a gift to God based upon the goodness that he's given to me. Let's pray. Father, how we love you, how we bless you, how we thank you. In this season of giving, we are grateful not just that you gave us Jesus, but thank you for the wonderful example of obedience we see in Joseph. Thank you for the sacrifice of Mary in giving her body to be used by you. And with two parents who were willing to sacrifice, thank you for a son like Jesus who gave even his life. We are so grateful. We celebrate them. We celebrate you. Receive now our gifts. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? The child that you delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know? Oh, Mary, did you know? Oh, the blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, and the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Your baby boy will one day rule the nation. Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The chiming child you're holding is the great I am.
Beautiful, beautiful rendition and wonderful song. Thank you, ladies. Awesome, awesome. I just want to stop for a moment and just give him praise. Pastor set it up when he said about the baby and about the obedience. What more can you say? I'm here to introduce to you today that our children are about to give a rendition of the birth of Christ. While you are watching, may this story speak to you right where you are. Listen to it. Find yourself in the story. See where the story of Christ intersects your own story. Are you Mary, receiving news? Shockingly? Are you Joseph, being challenged at this time? Are you Zechariah, in wonderment of God's awe of answering a prayer? Are you Simeon or Anna who waited a long time but yet received a promise? Are you waiting on a promise? Or are you Christ? You feel like right now the weight of the world is on your shoulder. Guess what? Present yourself. Enjoy. It shall be great.
Westside Baptist Church Children Ministry. Delvin Atchison, pastor. Rosalind Spencer, children pastor. Val Pagan, ministerial assistant. Nikki Thomas, nursery preschool. Kim Anderson, Awana Clubs. Whitney Milson, parent group. Carol Cody, attendance coordinator. The birth of Jesus Christ, the Savior of the world. Matthew chapter 1, 18 through 25. Chapter 2, 1 through 12. Luke chapter 1, 26 through 45. Luke chapter 2, 1 through 38. Written and digitally constructed by Pastor Rosalind Spencer. Enjoy.
The Lord our God has shared a prophecy with the prophet Isaiah.
A child will be born to us. A son will be given to us, and we will call him Wonderful Advisor and Mighty God and Prince of Peace.
In the sixth month after Elizabeth became pregnant, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, in a town in Galilee, to share news with Mary, who was engaged to Joseph.
Greetings, Mary. The Lord has blessed you in a special way.
Oh my!
Do not be afraid. The Lord is very pleased with you. You will become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must call him Jesus.
How can this happen? I am a virgin.
The Holy Spirit will come to you. The power of the Most High God will cover you. So the Holy One that is born will be called the Son of God.
I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would.
Joseph has seen Mary and has recognized that she is pregnant before they begin to live together as it is custom.
What must I do? I am faithful in the law. Maybe I could divorce her quietly so as to not shame her in public.
Well, yeah, two choices. You can stay married and say it is yours, or you can divorce her quietly so she is not publicly shamed.
Maybe I should just divorce her quietly. I do not want to shame her.
While Joseph is sleeping, Gabriel comes to him in a dream.
Joseph, the son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home to be your wife. The baby inside of her is from the Holy Spirit. She is going to have a son. You must name him Jesus.
The Lord will send you a son. The virgin is having a baby. She will have a son, and he will be called Emmanuel.
The Lord has spoken to me in a dream. I will do everything the angel has told me to do. I will take Mary to be my wife.
Zechariah and Elizabeth came from the family tree of Aaron, and they both did what was right in the sight of God, but had no children. Gabriel appears to John and Elizabeth.
Do not be afraid, Zechariah. Your prayers have been heard. Your wife, Elizabeth, will have a child. It will be a boy. You must call him John. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit even before he is born.
How can I be sure of this? I'm an old man, and my wife is old too.
I am Gabriel. I serve God. I have been sent to tell you the good news, and now you to be silent. You will not speak again until John is born.
Once Zechariah returned from home from the temple, shortly after, Elizabeth became with child.
The Lord has blessed me with a child. He has taken away my shame.
What is it that you are saying to me? And how again will this happen?
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will cover you. So the one that is born is the Holy One, the Son of God. Go now to your cousin Elizabeth. She has been with child for 6 months now. As you know, she could not have children, but God has blessed her.
Mary left very quickly to the hill country in Judea. As she entered Zechariah's house and greeted Elizabeth, the baby leaped inside Elizabeth, and Elizabeth became to speak by the power of the Holy Spirit.
God has blessed you, Mary, more than other women, and blessed is the child you will have. Mary, you are a woman of God. Do you believe God will keep his promises?
My soul gives glory to the Lord. My spirit delights in God, my Savior. He has taken note of me, even though I'm not considered important. From now on, people will call me blessed.
Mary stayed with Elizabeth 3 months and returned home. Elizabeth had her baby. Zechariah still has not spoken. At 8 days old, they took the child to the temple to be circumcised.
You should name the baby after his father, Zechariah.
No, he has to be called John.
None of his relatives have that name.
His name shall be called John.
What is this child going to be?
Give praise to the Lord, the God of Israel. He has come to his people to purchase their freedom.
Everyone had to go to their own town to be registered. Joseph and Mary went to the town of Bethlehem, the town of David.
It's time, Joseph!
There is no room at the inn. We must take shelter in the stables.
It will do. I can't travel any further.
Shepherds are in the field, keeping watch over their flock.
Be afraid. I bring you good news. It will bring great joy to all the people. And he is Messiah, the Lord.
Where can we find him?
We'll find the baby wrapped in cloth, lying in a manger.
Now, let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark sleep,
the shepherds find the baby lying in the manger.
It's just how they told us, the baby wrapped in cloth in a manger.
Hark, the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful all ye nations, rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem.
Jesus was circumcised at 8 days old. The law required that Mary be cleansed by offering, and that the firstborn boy be presented to the Lord. They took Jesus to the temple. As they walked in, they met Simon, who was a good godly man and had been waiting on God's promise to Israel to come true.
Do not worry, Simon. I told you that you would not die until you have seen the Messiah.
Lord, you are the King over all. Now let me, your servant, go in peace. That is what you promised. My eyes have seen your salvation. You have prepared it in the sight of all the nations. It is in the light to be given in the Gentiles. It will be the glory of your people Israel.
This child is going to cause many people to fall and to rise. God has sent him, but many will be against him. A sword will wound your own soul too.
Before they leave the temple, they meet Anna, the daughter of Penuel. She is very old and a widow.
Thanks be to God who has allowed me to see the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Now Jerusalem will be set free.
Today, I get to shine my light, and my light shows others where Jesus is.
Where is the child who came in the Jews and seen his stuff, and we came to worship him?
Bring me the teachers of the law. Teachers of the law, where is Messiah born?
In Bethlehem in Judea, where it is written by the prophets, O you Bethlehem
in the land of Judea, for a ruler can come out of you.
Bring me the wise men.
Yes, sir.
Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child.
They found Jesus just where the star showed them, at home with his mother and father, Mary and Joseph, in their home. He is 1 to 2 years old, and they presented him with gifts.
I was in gold.
Here, I present you frankincense. Here, I present you mirth.
God appeared to the wise men in a dream and told them not to go back to Herod. They obeyed, and Jesus grew and became strong. He was very wise. The end.
I told you. Did you not see yourself? I saw myself all over the place. So we're asking you now to present yourself to Christ. He came that we might live. He gave his life. But he was born to redeem us. Through his birth, we have the promise of the redemption of our very souls. Right where you are. If you already know him, think about what gift you need from him this Christmas. What can the baby Jesus do for you? For he is all grown up now, seated at the right hand of the Father. Also remember, you're never alone. Just like Gabriel approached them, you also have goodness and mercy following you all the days of your life. And our God, he is just a prayer away. I pray you look up to the hills with comfort, your help. It is ours to extend. It is yours to accept. We pray that you receive Jesus. Amen.
We thank you, Reverend Spencer, for your leadership in a creative and innovative way of sharing an old story that keeps making us new. Thank you for your leadership. My heart is touched, and I must confess that as Sister Dee Dee and the choir was singing that song, thought about how much joy I got every Sunday morning when we would do that song, because I knew God was gonna move and I knew people were gonna be coming. I would have them leave the front row empty because somebody needed life abundantly. I don't know how long it's gonna take, but I got a sneaking suspicion that the aisles are gonna fill again. That the front row is gonna be filled. And we'll get to sing as we do in unison. Come on, come on, come on to Christ. Somebody listening to me right now, you need to come to him right now. He'll give you life abundantly. And what's amazing is right in your living room, in your kitchen, in your bedroom, you don't have to move. God can change your situation and you don't even move from your location. He'll give you life abundantly. Oh, come. Right where you're invited me in. Oh, come. We offer Christ to you.
We offer Christ to you, oh my brother.
We offer Christ to you.
Offer Christ to you, oh my sister.
In the midst of a pandemic, give you a brand new life. New life abundantly. Oh, oh, come. On this Christmas, as we celebrate the birth of our Christ, this season of Advent, why don't you give Jesus the gift of you for his birthday? The Lord bless you and the Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon each of you and give you peace. Go, my family. And the Lord be with you. I love you, Westside Worldwide. I'll see you tonight for the men's musical at 7. We'll be right back.
week, and we will see you Sunday morning on Facebook, YouTube, WBCChurch.org, or the WBC mobile app.
Oh,